We had a lot of customers asking us to integrate Streamer directly into Zoom meetings and webinars, so we did that. Thanks for the suggestion. We call this new feature Streamer Zoom, and this video shows you how it works. If you've used Streamer much at all, you already know that we always do much more than just caption words, and we've done that with this new feature as well. Streamer Zoom can be set to just caption you, or to caption multiple presenters, or to caption everyone in the meeting. And automatically included in the captioning is the name of each person that is speaking, so you not only see what is being said, but also the name of the person that is saying it. When you use it, you'll immediately notice that the captioning appears much faster than if you hired a human transcriptionist. And if you want, you can have the captioning be displayed in your choice of over 100 languages. So if you're speaking English, and maybe a co-host is speaking French, the captioning for both of you could be shown in Spanish, Korean, Vietnamese, Hindi, Arabic, or pretty much any language that you want. And of course, with Streamer, each person can add their own personal notes to the transcript. With all these features, Streamer Zoom is really a nice way to caption your live meetings and webinars. Plus, it's easy to use. No downloads or installs are required. Just change one setting in Zoom, and copy a link into Streamer, and you're all set. Before we get started, in this video we assume you're already familiar with Streamer, including how to share your Streamer subscription with others. If you're not sure how to do that, then here's an additional video that you'll want to watch. Okay, let's show you how to use Streamer Zoom. First, that setting in Zoom that I mentioned. You need to add the closed captioning menu to your Zoom interface. You'll do this just once. Open your Zoom account, go to Settings, scroll about halfway down until you get to the In Meeting Advanced section, and turn on the closed captioning option. We also suggest you turn off the Save Captions option. Later in this video, I'll show you a much better way to save transcripts than doing it through Zoom. And that's it. Again, you just have to do this one time. Now, start your Zoom meeting or webinar just like you always do. And when you do that, you'll now see a closed caption icon in the Zoom menu bar. See this up arrow right next to the share screen icon? Note that right now there isn't an up arrow next to the closed captioning icon. There will be in a moment. I'm going to click on the closed captioning icon and select the Copy the API Token option. Okay, if you haven't done so already, go ahead and log into your Streamer account and select the room that you'll be using to caption your meeting. I then go to the Streamer Settings menu and select the Zoom Closed Caption option. And here is where you paste the API token that you copied. You can also set the size of the buffer for Streamer to use. The shorter the buffer, the faster the words will appear. But because Streamer uses both forward and reverse context to continually improve word accuracy, a short buffer means some of the updates may cause the captioning to jump a bit. I recommend that you use the medium or large size buffers. They add about a half second delay to the words appearing, but it smooths out the display, making it easier to read. And then click Start. Now you have to wait. It may take the Zoom servers up to 30 seconds to connect to the API token that you entered. Remember when I pointed out that the closed captioning icon didn't have an up arrow here? We're just waiting for that to appear. Once it does, then everything is synced and you're ready to start captioning. There, now I see the up arrow, and now you and everyone else that is participating in your meeting can click on the Show Subtitles option. They can also change the font size by using this settings mode. In this case, I made the font as large as possible, just so you can see it in this video. For this webinar, I'll select a screen to share, but you can use a live video as well. And then I'll click on the Show Subtitles option. Note that in the captioning, the name of the person that is speaking is always shown up here in the left corner. If someone else that has also logged into the Streamer room on their computer starts speaking, then you'd see their name displayed versus mine. It all happens automatically. So that's all it takes. As I promised, there are no downloads to perform or apps to install. Let's review the steps. First, as a one-time task, add the closed captioning icon to your Zoom menu. Then start Zoom and Streamer. The exact order in which you start them doesn't matter. In Zoom, copy the API token, and in Streamer, jump into the room you'll be using, and in the Streamer setting menu, select the Zoom closed caption option, paste the API token, and click Start. Then wait about 30 seconds for the menu to appear, and once it does, select the Show Subtitles option. And last but not least, with Streamer you can download a complete and easy to read transcript of your meeting that also includes a summary of the conversation. To do that, go to Streamer Settings, select the Download option, and save your transcript in whatever format you want. In addition to this video, here are two other ways you can use Streamer to caption live streams, such as Zoom meetings, Skype calls, WebEx webinars, and, well, basically anything. For closed captioning, here are the videos to watch. And here's the video to watch for open captioning. Thanks for taking the time to learn about Streamer Zoom, and thanks to all of you that suggested we add this feature. If you have additional ideas you'd like to see, let us know. And thanks for partnering with us in our goal of ensuring everyone can communicate with anyone, anywhere, anytime, and in most any language.